Hello everyone, this is BS Gamer here, welcoming you back to my Let's Play of Final Fantasy IV. And yes, you're hearing my voice for the first time. I'm gonna try and put in commentary for this episode. So off screen, I made my way over to Mist. There's some treasure you can pick up here. Most notably the polymorph rod, which I just got, and that gold hairpin. I'm gonna put on the gold hairpin, put the gold hairpin on Porum, and save the polymorph rod for later. Polymorph rod is really useful. Has a real good intellect stat boost. I'm gonna save that for a few bosses later. I'm not gonna put it on right now. Just save it for later. So, all the treasure chests I picked up are at Rydia's house. There's three more secret treasures we can get here, including that bomb fragment that I just picked up. Other than hidden items and treasure, nothing else much here. There is a weapon and armor shop, but the armor shop stinks. And there's a weapon called the Dancing Dagger, which is really good for Palom, but it's really expensive, so I'm going to pass on that. So that's all we can find at Mist for now. I'll meet you guys back at Baron Castle. Okay, we are back in Baron, and we are now going to continue through our main adventure. So this door that was locked here before, we can now unlock with the Baron key that we got from Yang in the last episode. And before you go down the stairs, you can go through the secret passage here, pick up this chest with 1,000 gil. Definitely do not want to skip that. Okay, now we are in the Ancient Waterway. Has everyone remaining in the castle gone over to the enemy? Foul things lurk in forgotten places. The darkness is gone from him, from his armor, and his soul as well. I sense monsters about. This must be their infernal lair. Ugh, awfully musty and moldy. Yeah, I like showing you guys the speech bubbles just to show you guys what the characters are thinking in certain places. There are some lines that are pretty funny later on, so you guys look forward to that. Okay, we've got a new enemy here. The killer fish we fought before in the, I forget what that cave is called, good lord, we fought the, I think it's the under, yeah, the underground waterway, there we go. But the splashes are new. Not that tough. Any kind of thunder spell will do wonders on them. And there you go, they're not that tough. Ooh, wow, a high potion, very nice. Got another new enemy here, these are Giga Skaters. They are weak to ice, so ice spells will work well on them. And there you go.
They're not that tough either. They do hit kind of hard though with their physical attacks. So watch out for that. Alright, we have completed the map here. We have obtained 3 high potions. Now we are in the B3 area. This area can be a little bit of a pain in the neck to fill out the map, so watch real closely how I do it. Oh, great. Got a new enemy here. These are electrofish. They absorb thunder, so do not use thunder attacks on them. It is a very bad idea. In fact, I need to have Yon defend here. Because if Yong attacks with his thunder claws, the electrofish will absorb it. They're really annoying enemies, but they don't have a lot of HP, so they don't take long to kill. Cecil leveled up and he reached over 1,000 HP. Very nice. Cecil is going to be the tank of this game. Like, he's going to have a lot of HP and a lot of physical defense. So watch his, he has the highest amount of HP out of any character in the game, so look for the HP to skyrocket. Alright, we get a spider silk, so now we have to backtrack. In the 2D versions of Final Fantasy IV, there's actually a way you can get through this wall, but in the 3D versions there isn't. You have to backtrack. Whoa, another new enemy. Devil's Castanet. Again, weak to thunder. Okay, while I'm battling, I guess I'm going to talk about this game a little bit. Final Fantasy IV, this is my favorite game I've ever played. Ever. I'm not even kidding. This game is awesome. I love the soundtrack and the characters. Most of the characters anyway. I do not like Edward. I mean, it's the soundtrack that I like the most. I actually fell in love with this game because of a specific song. It's actually the boss battle theme of this game. I first heard that theme when I was... Ooh, a diet ration. Anyways, what I was saying is that I fell in love with this game because of the boss battle theme of Final Fantasy IV. I first heard this theme when I was playing Super Mario RPG Legend of the Seven Stars. And I don't know why, I just fell in love with that theme. It's because it's awesome, that's why. Okay, I'll leave this battle in. So yeah, that's how I fell in love with this game. I actually wanted to try it out because I've never heard of Final Fantasy until I heard that song in Super Mario RPG when I was battling QLX. And I have played other Final Fantasies. This one is my favorite.
Yes, I even like it better than Final Fantasy VII. I'm sorry, this game's better than Final Fantasy VII. I don't know, I just thought Final Fantasy VII was overrated. Hermes sandals. Whoa, a leather cap. Howling's level increased. Ooh, you learned Toad. Probably never gonna use that spell though. Actually, I will later on, but not with Palum. Why am I not getting through the wall? Ugh. Goodness, these guys actually hit really hard. Hey, I don't know why I was having trouble getting through that wall there. I apologize for screwing up. So, hopefully you guys like my commentary. I'm sorry if I sound a little boring right now. Once I start fighting the really hard enemies later on, that is when my commentary is probably going to start going, will actually start being entertaining, because I'll be cussing a lot, that's for dang sure. Thank you for dying.
There we go, good. Can I get through, please? Thank you.
Oh my god. Okay, you know what? Fuck this, I'm running. Run. I don't want to fight you guys. Run away. Thank you. That was obnoxious. Alright, we obtained an ether for completing the B3 map. Alright, this next room will actually be very easy to fill out. Make sure you go through this secret passage here. And look at that, we already completed it. We get 3 remedies for completing it as well. It's actually a very good reward here. Be sure to pick up that chest as well. Alright, we only need to fill out B1. The map on B1. Look at that, we reached the save point. Oh wait, there is more, there's a secret passage here. Alright, in this chest we get an ancient sword. Now, this sword is for Cecil. However, the attack isn't very good. The accuracy isn't as good as the Mythgraven Blade. That sword, however, is non-elemental, and it has a slight chance of cursing an enemy, but I'm not going to use it. I prefer more attack power. Alright, I'm going to stop the episode here. That's all for this episode of Final Fantasy IV. In the next episode, we will continue going through the underground waterway, or the ancient waterway. I'll see you guys then.